أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين ثم الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين محمد بن عبد الله عليه أفضل الصلوات وأتم التسليم أوصي نفسي وأنفسكم بتقوى الله عز وجل قال تعالى في القرآن العظيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. After praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, I send the salutations to the beloved messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us each and everything which our hearts desire. Allahumma ameen. It is a privilege to be here with you this evening, and to me it's my first time to be here. Of course, I've been seeing my brother Sheikh Hussein Ali Bulafu. We've been discussing a lot behind the cameras about the program which we are running here every Friday after Salatul Asr. Allow me, inshallah, to introduce myself. I'm by the name Amjad Sebumba. I am a teacher by profession. I teach at Chinawa High Schools, that is Chinawa High School, Kawempe Campus, and Chinawa High School, Chengera Mugongo Main Campus. I studied from Islamic University in Uganda. That is my bachelor's degree in Islamic Studies and Arabic Language. Then after, I joined Islamic University in Uganda, Kampala Campus, in a bachelor's degree in Sharia, in a master's degree in Sharia al-Islamiyya. Now, I'm very glad to be here with you. Nsaba Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala atuwe obulungi obukunganira mu kifo kino, era atuwe buli kimu kye twagala, atukingirize n'ebikyamu ebiyinza tutuukako oboolyawo nga tetumanyi, era tukingirize n'abalabe. And I think we shall be mixing the languages which we'll be using. Of course, I'll be using a little bit of Luganda, and then at the same time, English, inshallah ta'ala. Now, according to the series which we have been with my brother Sheikh Hussein Ali Bulaf, from the beginning, where he was talking about the marriage from its first step, kuvira ddala ng'omuntu tonnaba kufuna mukyala, ng'oli mu process ey'okugenda okufuna omukyala oba maama w'abaana bo ewaka. That process is a little bit challenging, because in most cases bantu bangi bosanga ng'emyaka gy'alina Allahu subhanahu wa ta'ala tannaba kumusobozesa kufuna mukyala oba nga tannaba kumusobozesa kufuna muki mwami. Naye Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ensonga ze yatulaga together with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the things which my brother Sheikh Hussein talked about, which we have to follow so that you get a righteous spouse according to the religion of Islam and according to the teachings of the beloved messenger Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ebintu ebyo bwe tuba tubigoberedde okuviira ddala ku ntandikwa, there are the things which we base on to be with a righteous family. Fenna abali wano, we are willing, or we might be willing, to be with righteous kids. Naye abaana abalongoofu batandikira straight away from the mother of your kids, or the mother of them. Bw'obanga wagoberera obukwakkulizo ne conditions eze tuyitamu okubeera nga tufuna omukyala mu busiraamu omulongoofu, and when the first condition is all about the religion, the moment you get a righteous spouse who is religious, that is the first indication that maybe inshallah abaana b'ogenda okufuna oba b'ogenda okuba nabo nabo bagenda kubeera baki bagenda kubeera balungi. Now mu lugendo olwo lwe tubaamu olw'okunoonya omukyala oba olw'okunoonya omwami, the first condition we have to follow, ekisooka kubikwasa Allahu subhanahu wa ta'ala. Waliwo aya Allahu subhanahu wa ta'ala gye yayogerako mu Quran, whereby we have a lot of things which we want. Bwetunulako to the side of our sisters, in their books, butawo waabwe bwe baba nabwo, they have their condition which they have to follow or which they are supposed to follow in order to get a man. Waliwo abamu nga yayina points ze 12 as outlining. And when you are to see them or when you are to talk about them, ugendo laba, number one, omusajja must be with money, which is not bad. But the first point to follow must be omusajja aline dini. Is he religious? Because even the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was telling us to choose the righteous wives, yayogera ku condition zizonna zonna, kyemmanyi we are just making a recap, kyemmanyi ze twayogerako. Naye muzimu ku zo bwe yali amaliriza, he said fadfar bi dhati din talibat yadak, if you want to be with a righteous wife, mind about her religion. Beauty, yes, it is supposed to be there, the wealth, the family where she is coming from, but the first condition to follow must be her religion. When we look in the history of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and here comes the point or the topic which we are going to share today. Ta'amul an-nabiyyi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ma azwajihi aw ma zawjatihi. After getting a wife, after getting a husband, now we have started the life of marriage. Obufumbo bwaffe tukoze ki? Tubutandise. Omuntu, in the first place, if you want your marriage to be successful, number one, you have to choose the best role model. Yes, we are having very many people who are married. I might be there when I am single. Ngachimanyi Sheikh wange Hussein mufumbo. Now, if I want my marriage to be successful, I should be with a role model. Naye, we have to also mind about these role models, not that each and every person, oh, you know, muko pako nga bwatambuza obuchi, obufumbo we, no. Okay? Because nze wange, I might be living emitwalo etaano nga sente za kameza. Now, if you are to make me your role model, it means now you might end up nga nawe sente za kameza zoleka emitwalo emeka etaano. Now, if I live enkumi biri, I know how my wife plans with that nkumi biri. Okay? But the best role model to choose must be our beloved messenger Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you want to live in a happy and a successful marriage, go back and read the history of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, how he dealt with his beloved wives. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yalina ebintu ebyenjawulo mu bulamu bwe obw'obufumbo bye yatambulirangako. Oboolyawo, for his marriage to be successful, and they are the points which we are going to remind ourselves about. The first point, as a married man, I'm sorry, I'll go to the side of the man, because in most cases ladies say fe we tuba tugenda okufumbirwa batubuulirira, naye abasajja bwe baba bagenda otuwasa tutuukayo nga fe baakola ki, baatubuulirira, ng'abasajja bo tebaakola ki, tebaababuulirira. In the first place of choosing the role model, we said that role model must be our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was a role model to the family members, to the wives. The first point, musa'adatuhunna fi a'mali al-manzil. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to help all the wives when it came to the issues concerning the home or the house. Okufumba, okwera, okusimula, okola bichi, okamente, okutwala ente kutale, each and everything. That was the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. But the question is, are you that kind? Gwe ng'omusajja oba ng'omwami gwe walonda ewuwe wakaawo, is he of that kind? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallama kana yahtamu bikhadmi nafsihi. In the first place, yalinga ye kenyini nyini yeyamba mu mirimu gye. Oba tuli fenna, you might be in a situation ng'oli waka with your husband. Naye nga each and everything omwami akisaba gwe. Sokisi zange ziriwa, nti muna ekanzu gye nzikuwe. Ekanzu yange gye njagala okwambala leero, you find out that the kanzu which was ironed is of cream color and for you want to put on black. Now you tell her, eya cream gye wagolodde sikola ki, sijagala ngololere lye yaki, eya black. Are we together, members? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallama used to help his beloved wives mu mirimu egyewaka. Kana yakhsifu na'alahu. He used to clean and wash his clothes. Wa yarqa'a thawbahu. At times when the wives were busy, he used to wash his clothes. Wa yahlibu shatahu. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallama used to go n'alaba ebisolo bikomyewo, engamiya zikomyewo, embuzi zikomyewo, n'agenda n'akama amata, n'aleetera omukyala n'akola ki, n'afumba in the first place. That's why when Khadija radiyallahu anha was asked about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallama, how he used to conduct himself at home, Khadija said, kana yakhsifu na'alahu wa ya'malu ma ya'malu ar-rajulu fi baytihi. Khadija said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallama used to do each and everything at home. A minimum sajja jakole waka nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallama yajikolanga, and we know them. But you might find a situation whereby omukazi waka yafumbe mmere, yakima amazzi we gaba gaweddewo ku ttaapu, bw'oba olina ebintu by'osindisa oba by'oleese waka gw'obisituza, gwe n'otambula nga lunsa. Are we together? Nabbi sallallahu alayhi wa sallama was exemplary in the family where he was. Nga ye kenyini nyini in the first place, he was the role model. Okay? Era nabbi sallallahu alayhi wa sallama, the second point, tahammuluhu wa sabruhu alayhinna. As a man, as a husband at home, you have to be patient from each and everything which the wife might do. I have a friend of mine, Sheikh Yasir. He told me one day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created these ladies. Ngabo, they get pleased that very moment wokoledde ekintu. Yangamba omukyala asiima ekintu wokoze eki wokikoledde. An example on this. If you buy, for example, KFC and you bring it home, omukyala awo wakola ki? That very moment wasiimira. Even asobola n'okumaliriza okulya KFC yo gy'oleese with the lot of money you used. Namala nagamba naye musajja gw'olimba, you have never done anything good to me. Naye nga mu ddakiika ttaano ava kulya ki? KFC. Tuli fenna. Also, this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created them. Now, if we know them, we have to be patient with each and everything which they might do. And all the time we have to expect bad things from them. Expect okuyomba, expect okuvumamu, expect okugamba nti tolina kye wali onkoledde. Are we together, members? After getting all of them, now you have to be patient. Bw'osanga yo abasajjasajja yayanguyirawo awe bamugamba, musajja gwe tolina kye wali onkoledde n'ekimu, empinga zikola ki? Mumchala ne mchala gweto sima wano nakoledde kino ne kino ne kino ne kino Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala watu bo yawatonda. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallama was very patient with his beloved wives. Remember a situation where all the wives gathered in front of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallama and they started to question him. Ne bamugamba naye nabbi leka kusaaga. Buno obwavu bwe tuwangaliramu, we are living in the worst life. And which is true, because the Prophet lived in a life of a normal person, omuntu owa bulijjo. Time reached, ng'akomawo n'ewaka for lunch, nga tewali lunch n'abuuza Aisha, are we having food? Then Aisha could say no. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam could bring the near of fasting. Naga, waba tewali mmere kati nkozeeki, nsiibye. Now the wives gathered, all of them, you know, had 12. Ne bakungana, ne bamuteeka mu kajojijoji w'ebibuuzo. They started to ask him, but ya Rasulallah, you are Allah's messenger. You are the best among all the creatures. Whatever you want, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can give it to you. Lwaki tosaba Allah n'atuggya mu bwavu buno bwe tulimu n'atuwa ssente zitamanya alina? Ah! Nabbi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ne bimusobera. N'atuula. Gamba okay. And he waited for the answer from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala n'abaita bakyala ba Nabbi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Jibril nasse obubaka. Allah n'abazza mu layini baali bawabye. Allah mukubazza mu layini n'abagamba nti bagambe Muhammad, tell them to come. If they want to be rich, I am going to provide money to them. But on one condition, baba tebakyali bakyala bo. Bwe mmala okubawa ssente nga buli gwempa ayagala okufuna ssente, muwa ssente n'akola ki? N'avaawo. Naye Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, wa in kunna turidna Allaha wa rasulahu. If they want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and their prof and the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, now they must be patient with each and everything which is going on in our lives. In the marriage life, we have to be patient from one another. Chala byakoze uminkirize. At times you may come back kusawa zonya, na even the supper is not prepared. Does that mean that you have to get mad? No, that shouldn't be the issue. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallama was very patient concerning the matter of the wives and concerning the matters which were there at home. Okay? Even the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallama, sente ye yali awo ng'alina sente empitirivu zaaleka ewaka. You know, we are living in an era whereby abakyala they consider sente za kameza more than each and everything. Musajja oyo gw'olaba tandikirawo sente za kameza, tandabirira, tanfaako. But naffe ffennyini nyini, we have to be patient with our husbands, the ones we are having. Among the conditions which we follow, it is a twalaba, when we are going to get a husband or a wife, we say the first condition should be the religion. And then, omusajja in that very moment, ayinza okubanga, he does not have that much amount of money. Naye ng'emikisa gye gy'okufuna ssente nagyo myanjulu kufuera nga weegiri. Now we have to be patient, both sides, okulaba nga tutambuza ensonga n'okutambuza obufumbo bwaffe nga tuli bulungi era nga tewali kintu kyonna kyonna kyetukomplaininga, either complaining to the side of the husband or complaining to the side of the wife. The third point, sabruhu sallallahu alayhi wa sallama ala ma yaqa' minhunna min tasarrufatin mukhtalifa. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was very patient with all the changes which his wives were experiencing, mostly in life. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us when we cannot live in the constant situation. Buli kimunga tutambulanga bwe twakibala. We live in the life whereby we experience ups and downs. Kati Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallama used to be patient with the wives according to the way they were changing in one in either ways. You know, these wives tend to change naturally, most especially wabali imbuto. Bachiuka. The same thing, nafa abasajja bwobanga obadde oyinamu ku sente, sente ne zituuka ekiseera ne ziggwawo, naawe era okola ki? Okyuka. Now, enkyukakyuka eyo mu bulamu, we have to bear with it and we have to know that that is life. Aisha, radiyallahu anha, the wife of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallama, she narrates and she says, لقد رأيت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يوما على باب حجرتي. One day I was able to see the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم standing at the door of my bedroom. Okay? والحبشة يلعبون في المسجد. وليا بسجى بابيلي أبدوغافو. They were playing in the mosque. كاتي عائشة radiyallahu anha nava mu kisenga jena yakola ki alaba abasajja abakola ki abalwana, because the prophet's house okujiga enangamu yayitanga mu ki yayitanga mu muzikiti n'agenda n'ayingira mu kisenge kyewa mu kisenge kya Aisha. Naye Aisha says that when I came to see those ones who were playing in the mosque, fabada ar-rasulu sallallahu alayhi wa sallama yasturuni biridaihi. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallama started to cover me with a cloth. Abali wabwere eri balime kulaba nti ne Aisha naye akola ki ayimiridde waawo. Kama annahu kanu yunadiha bil humaira. The same thing, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallama used to call his beloved wives sweet names. Naye gwe buli lucha noyita mama gundi, namuddu, nasaka, nakijoba, jangu wana, I want food. Get that one name which you call your husband, which you call your wife. Naye gwe buli kiseera gwe sema kookiro, gwe sema kawawano, gwe sebuufu. Are we together? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallama was very patient in each and every condition in the matters regarding marriage. The fifth point, mushawaratuhunna wal ihtimam bi ara'ihinna. In the marriage life, you have to respect the idea and the advice from either your wife or your husband. How? Oli ayinza okubeera awo a husband and then he gets something either ku mulimu gy'akolera oba abantu bawangaala nabo, and then he comes back home with a gloomy face. Okay, mukyala akanya kubuuza owaye kiki, ah biveeko ebyo. The same story might happen to the side of the wives. Nobeerawo nga you are having very many challenges, but you can't share them with your husband. This is not the case. If we look at the history, we might see that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the first place, Allah wa yamuwa mchale ya soka Khadija binti Khuwailid. She used to advise the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam a lot. In which way? Number one, yali asinga nabi obukulu. Because the Prophet married her when she was 40 years, when the Prophet was 25 years. Khadija yali asinga nabi emyaka 10 n'emeka 15, which might not be the case. Msajja inzo banga kusinga emyaka 10, obanga kusinga emyaka 2, but that advice matters a lot. Among the things which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave these ladies, Allah yabawa obwongo n'okulowooza, which he never gave us fa abasajja. fe Allah amagezi gaffe yagatuweera muki mu maanyi. Gwe bw'olaba ng'olina amaanyi ng'olowooza nti n'okutegeera okola ki, otegeera nnyo. Allah bw'atyo we yabikola, bo yabawa amagezi nga mangi nnyo okusukuluma ku gaabani ku gaffe. That's why when we are going to marry, among the things which we have to consider, the age of the wife. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, tazawwaju alwaluda alwaduda. If you are to marry, marry a wife who is younger than you. Bobo ine miaka asatu, funayo karo owe miaka abidi, owe owe kumi no munana. Natural oyogo wenkanyana yamachi amagezi. Bwaba ine miaka abiri, chitegeza her thinking capacity ya muntu ine miaka ameka asatu. Yes. Eh, obadde tochimanyi professor, professor akademu. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us fa abasajja nga amaanyi gaffe oba endowooza yaffe esinga, we take it mu maanyi getukola ki, getulina. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave these ladies the thinking capacity. Omukyalo ow'emyaka ekkumi n'omunaana alowooza ng'omusajja ow'emyaka ameka? Asatu. Omukyalo ow'emyaka abiri asobola okulowooza ng'omusajja ow'emyaka ameka? Ana. That's why the challenges which we are facing mostly ku bantu ababeera in marriage nga they are of the same age, always omukyala bw'abaako ne kyayogera aba alaba nga she is making a point, ate nga togenda kukola ki, kumuwakanya. Era naawe bw'okoma weewaka nga kyoyogedde oyagala ki ekiba kikola ki, kyekiba kikola. Remember you are of the same age. Olina 25, alina 24. Oba mwenna mwenna mulina 25, 25. Endowooza yammwe tesobola kwenkana abadan. Aba alowooza nnyo maaso okusinga gwe. That's why they plan a lot. And I'm giving an example of all yao je tuinzo kutegeerera kenyo. In the life which we are living in right now, ngaba sajja, if I'm to ask a question, wamma, boba wa kulia ranch, kulia sente meka. Eh. Oyinza kulia sente meka ranch. Ngosazeo olie bulungi choya gala. Aha, how much? Omutwa gukola ki? Gugwao. Okay. That is lunch. Are you together, members? Now there is evening tea. Hey, I'll regula nobuda this time. Eh? Enkumitano. That is gumu chitundu. Bwoba musambi wa kapiira n'ogendako mu kisaawe n'osamba akaki kapiira. Now you are having supper. Ogenda okuva eyo oba ovudde ku mulimu, enjala ekulumye, okooye. Now you have to take supper. Awo zibeera mmeka? Tuve mu bali abaakakomanda ak'ebbiri. Okay? We are talking about someone alya a meal which is supposed to be taken. Kale tugambe nti era awo 15 nazo zikola ki? Zigenze ziweddewo, kitegeeza a day you have used emitwalo emeka? Ebiri. Billahi lazim, give 5,000 to a wife at home, ojja kulaba ebyewuunyo. Oyinza n'okukomawo nga lanchi yafumbye enkoko. Okay? Because nowadays they sell enkoko in quarter, half kilo, a whole chicken. Okay? I want to drive you to what I was saying. Gwe olunaku okulyako obulungi oli emitwalo emeka? Ebiri. A wife at home can plan for 5,000 nga mugenda kulyako lunch ne supper. N'agula half y'omuceere, nagula ennyaanya za bibiri akatungulu ka kikumi worst of it all nafisa nawo k'olukumi are we together nafunayo olukumi lwa data oba olwaki oba olwe airtime. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the first place advised us. Bobango ine miaka jolina. Yes, you are in your 30s. At least you get someone who is in 20s. Okay? Olaba na aba 20s na uwe njini njini ilaba sumbuwa. Gwenu kula, wallahi mchalo nusicham tegeira. Are we together? So, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to mind a lot about the advice which was given to him from the wives. Era Khadija, radiyallahu anha, is known to be the master planner of the Prophet's call when the Prophet was still calling the Muslims fi da'awati sirriya. Nabibu yali akola abantu okusiramuka in the first place. The first person eyamuyirawo omubiri ng'enjogera y'ennaku zino was Khadija. And we know it very well that Khadija ye mukyala yasooka okukola ki okusiramuka without no any explanation. Because the Prophet came to her, n'amunyumiza story ya malayika emujjidde. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling him that you have to publicize the call, you have to start calling others towards the religion of Islam. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as he was talking to Khadija, Khadija waited for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to wake up. Nabi amaro kuzukuka, Khadija namuga hana umburira. Mudobo zerikakam. Here we get something to learn. Bwetubere waka. Even if you are annoyed, oba mchala ya kunyiziza, oba kumulimu jova, when you come back home, please and please kakana, as if waberenge watali wachintucho nachona chakuzechi, chakutuseko. But this habit of coming back home, nebi zibu vyo kumulimu nokolachi, nobirete waka. They are telling you the sugar is over, na mwe, and even the soap oba sabuni mulia mulie. Because you were disturbed from the things which happened to you ngochari wa. Ngochari yeri bari. Now Khadija told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what is the issue? The Prophet told Khadija that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told me to call others towards the religion of Islam. Mpita abantu bajje bakolechi basiramuke. Uliro mchalo mulongofu. Ya mugamba ya Rasulallah. Ana awwalu man amana bika. Ya mugamba my beloved husband. I am the first person to believe in the religion which you have come with. And I'm ready to do each and everything so that the religion of Islam can be successful. Era buli kimu yabijja kikola. Because one, she had a lot of money. Yaina saint. Ngava mu family ya kitiibwa, she had connections. Era abasigaddawo abajja, they used to follow the advice which Khadija gave to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is not that each and everything which we are doing, we have to hide them from our wives. No. At times they be with ideas. Na yo olwaleero tuli ku mulembe ng'omusajja ayagala akole buli kimu ky'ayagala ng'omukyala takola ki tamanyi ogukyala ogwo guyinza okunziba. Are we together? And at times that depends ku mukyala naawe gwe wakola ki gwe waleeta ewaka. Naye nga tukikakasa bulungi nti waliyo abakyala nga you can tell her all your plans nazikuuma nga mwe mwabiri mwe muzimanyi nga she can tell you all her plans and you advise. But this habit of mchalo gamo msajjo wa eno wali njirizayo kawo emilioni nga satu ogena kola chibili yao. Are we together? you have to get advice from one another. That is what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to do when he was in the marriage life together with his beloved wives. Tulifena. Now, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, among the ways oba mu mbeera ez'enjawulo ze yayitangamu to marry the wives he had, yalinanga ebintu eby'enjawulo bye yakola ki bye yasinziirangako mu mbeera emu oba endala, which we all suppose to follow. Ebimu ku byo, there are some ladies which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam married after the death of their husbands. Nga mukuwasa abakyala abo, there is goodness, and they are the most, they are the many which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam married. Omukyala yekka nabbi gwe yawasaako nga tafumbirwangako yali Aisha radiyallahu anha. Era Aisha n'okwewaana yeewaananga in front of others, the co-wives, nga bagamba tazawajani nabi ya bikra. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam married me nga sifumbirwangako. Tazawajani nabi bi amri min Allah. The Prophet married me and it was an order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Kati mwe bajjabanga basigadde simanche mungamba. Are we together? Naye nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, after marrying her, remember, in the first place he had only one wife, Khadija. Era ebbanga nabbi sallallahu alayhi wasallam lye yamala ne Khadija radiyallahu anha, he never married any other wife until when Khadija died. Now there are sisters here who are saying, nange omwami wange bwababa, but are you having the guarantee that you are going to die first? Are we together? We shouldn't make this a point that nange musajja wange alina kukola ki, ninasooka kukola ki, kufa. Kitegeeza bwoba olina sooka kufa, awo muzimu ku dduwa ze tuba tulina okusaba ewaka Allah omukyala ono mutte mangu, which is not right. Okay, so according to the Prophet's way of marriage, according to how Khadija used to treat him, yabeera naye nga ali nayo omukyala atya omu. Are we together, members? She used to advise him in very many things and in very many occurrences. After the battle of Uhud, we know it very well that waliwo abantu bebaleta, the non-Muslims bebaleta, bebajja abawambe bebafuna muki mu lutalo. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam started to seek for advice from various people. Nga buli bamu agenda abagamba, what should we do with them? Umar ibn al-Khattab n'abagamba, ya Rasulallah, naktuluhum, we kill them. Uyo munaga yiyi nti ya Rasulallah, we kill them. After killing them, tewali muntu agenda kuddamu kuzanya na buki na busiramu. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam went to Khadija, to Uthman, and even to others. But one of the things which they advised him, they told him, ya Rasulallah, let us make them to teach our children how to read and how to write. That is the advice from a wife to a husband. Bachala binaku zinote, bachayagala kutuwa bula. I don't know whether nafa abasajja fe tutete kamulevo ya kubanti tukolachi tuwabulwa. Because oli ayinza okubeera nga Ssaabasajja buli kimu kyayagala ewaka kyekikolachi kyekikola. But that shouldn't be the point. As a husband at home, you have to be exemplary. Waliwo abamu abalina abaana nga abaana oluwulira either emmotoka nga ekuba engombe ku geeti, obanga waliwo akonkona oba bubadde bulaba TV nga budduka pakawa mu kisenge, daddy akomyewo, kisenge tukole ki, kiveemu. That shouldn't be the point. Are you that kind of husband ng'omukyala bw'akuwulira ng'okomyewo aga ha inna lillahi wa inna ilaihi raji, era omuntu akomyewo? Okay, we have to create a peaceful environment at home with our wives, with our husbands. We have to accept whenever they tell you that you have done something wrong. Accept if it is wrong. Tochitwala gamanti ya nze nabu Kenya waku no bangamba ko. It shouldn't be that. There is no any person in this life gwebatagamba ko. There is no any person in this life atawabulwa. Even the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, kullu ibn Adam khata'a wa khayral khata'ina at-tawabin. Everyone does something wrong, but the best wrongdoer is the person who come to know that I have done a mistake, but I am sorry, I will never repeat that again. Okay? The last point, the second last, which we are going to talk about how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to deal with his beloved wives. Mu'amalatuhunna bil mawaddati war rahma. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as a husband, yajifula point to be with his wives in a peaceful way. Nga obuwangazi bwabwe obufumbo bwabwe bujuddemu okusaasirigana n'okwagalana. That's why one of the stories which we get to learn from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which shows that he was merciful, nga alina omukwano, alina ekisa eri bakyala be, one day yayingira at the place or at the house of Safiya. Safiya was one of the Prophet's wives. Wahiya tabki. The Prophet entered. When Safiya was crying, binayiye, hata omuntu gwe nalese nga ali musanyu. Why is she crying? Fasa'alaha an sababi bukaiha. The Prophet asked her, Safiya, why are you crying? Faqalat, Safiya said, inna Hafsa ayyaratuha bi annaha binti Yahudiya. Hafsa, the co-wife, told her that you are a daughter of a Jewish person or a Jewish man. Oli mwana wabachi? Wabaju, oba wabayahudi. Ah! Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wakati orutalo lugenda kugwa rutya. This happens a lot to wives who are more than one. Ebiso omo za tebigwamu. Eranga the same thing, erebuba na yote likola chi, telisobola kugwao. Now look at the incident. Nga Safiya alopani, muja we Hafsa, because of telling her nti mwana wa muchi wa Yahudi. Now according to the way the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to deal with the wives, na mugamba nti Safiya mchala wange, ya mugamba nti innaki labnati nabij. Safiya, from today onwards njagalo chitegere nti you are a daughter of a prophet. Oli muwala wani wa nabbi. Wa inna ammaki la nabij, and your uncle is also a prophet. Wa innaki la tahta nabij, and best of it all, your husband is also a prophet. Fabima tafkharu alayki. Now, is there anything which you have to be proud with except that? Okubanga gwe oli mwana wachi wa nabbi, nga kojao nabbi, atenga no mwami wani nabbi, au nabbi sawa salama uriyombo taruzikiza, nebu batalimazeo. Okay? Now, in the lives which we are living in, we have to learn how to treat our wives in a merciful way. And we have to show them love. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after he told Hafsa that itaqillaha ya Hafsa, fear Allah, Hafsa, tiani, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not only that, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after marrying Aisha radiyallahu anha, nga Aisha kali kachala, nga kachali katono burunji, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took her somewhere and he made a starting line here. He told her, we are going to run. 100 meters. The one who reaches first is the winner. Abasoma tarehe tuchimanyi nabi ya wasa ishanga wami akemeka. Wanji, 9 years. Okay? Na ye 9 years, seja wane wafe Uganda. Wane Uganda, bachapa wababana wafe tubalisa kumikopa, kumiwogo, nebilala, nebatakula mangu. Ababa wala buboba siva kunkoko, matagangamia, zamzamu, nebilala, nebakulachi, mangu. Now after marrying her, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told her, we are going for a race. Na asaza line wane soka. Na agena na asaza neri, the finishing line. They started to sprint. Given the fact that Aisha was still young and energetic, naduke misinde na ita kunabi nabite yalaba wo ya ita. Aswai! And she crossed the line. Now she started to jubilate. Nkusinze walai, nkusinze. Are we together? The Prophet waited for some few years. You know, we tend to marry these wives of ours when they are still models. When they are models. Manawo mulaba, keko. Walai, even when you are talking about why you say, kachara kangeje kariye wakeyo. After some years, Aisha yatani kokolachi. Ogeja. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam got an idea. Nebadayo in the same place. Weba mpaka ziri wezari. He crossed the first line, the starting line. And he crossed the finishing line. Amugamba Aisha. Yes, my husband. We have come back the second time. We are going to run. Aisha yena geze geze emera alide mpitirivu. Now this time round nabi weyaduka ye yakolachi ye yasoka yo na ene ye wana nti nange nkozechi nkusose au negubere emwemu na ye wali gwali emu zero. Okay, are we those kind of husbands who play with our wives at home? Are we the ones obagwokanya gama nti wallahi bya Nigeria bya film? No, it shouldn't be the point. Are you that kind of wife who create a peaceful environment at home which makes your husband to be free to do each and everything? Okay? Waliwo kati buno obuzannyo obupya, lete chupa, simana ojikasuka bwetuulawo, you do something. Mwani yabagamba nti buno obuzannyo bw'empi, you put your hands like this, no yauza, wa misinganga nawe okola ki? Omukuba. It is one of the things which are going to add love between us as the husbands and as the wives. Okay? The last point which we are going to talk about how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallama or the Prophet's relationship with his wives. Adluhu ma'ani sa'ihi. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallama, given the fact that he had very many wives, he did each and everything bono kubenkanya nkanya. Even though naturally mubamu nawe gosingo kolachi okwagala, but at least you try. If in this house ewa nambe mubagenda kulya matoke, why are you making it a point ateri ewa namba bili yoba lye kaunga ka muwogo? Kale bw'oboguza ekiwagu kisale mu wakati eno batwaleyo party neri batwaleyo ki party, not to be there nga gwe omanyi nti ewa nambe mu, yes banambe mu baina mu co privilege kuba tuba twakola ki twatoba nabo bulamu twatandika nabo twawafuna de tunafuna sente Mungu bwazi tuwane tulyoka tukola ki ne tulyoka tuwasa. That is what they say. It is not my ideology. Okay? But also the ladies, we have to know it very well. You know, there is a question which I ask the ladies whenever it comes to matters concerning okunga tako bo butanga tako. I ask them, I give them two options. Number one, your husband to marry your sister, not even your co-wife, your sister in Islam. And you get to know that if my husband is not this side, Ariwani, Ariwa Hafswa, Oba Ariwa Mariam. Okay? That is the first option. The second option, if my husband is not here, I know he will come back. He is free to do each and everything he wants, to love as many girls he wants, and to sleep with as many as possible, provided he comes back home on a daily basis. Ngaba sirisate. There are two options. Omusajja okubeerawo nga bw'aba tali wuwo kimanya ali waani wa mulala. Oba okola ebintu byeyo because tubikola. Tesobola kwegaana nti tetubikola. Tubikola n'okola ebintu byeyo n'okomawo ewaka on a daily basis. Oh, okubeerawo ng'okimanyi nti bw'aba tali wano ewange ali eno, I can give a one call away and I know how the husband is doing. Abamu bagamba, hey, afazali akola byakola ebibyeyo n'akola ki? N'akomawo. But now you do not look at the dignity which you are having. Perhaps the man might come back home ng'alina byakoze ebiki. Some diseases ng'afunye endwadde ate n'azireetewa ewaka. Okay? And when we start to talk about that point, ng'abakyala banyiiga. Era some of them say that abasajja azifu mu Qur'ani baategeerayo fankihu matwaba lakum minan nisa'i mathna wa thulatha wa ruba'a. But now in the world which we are living in, we even know it very well and better that the ladies are many more than the what? The man or the men. Banji. The only way yetusobola okubakeezaako kwe kubanga Seeka Hussein afunyeyo namba bbiri. Oboolyawo n'afunayo namba ssatu ne namba nnya n'ayamba umma. Abasigaddewo baleme kubeera baki? Baleme kubeera nga nabo bali awo they are looking for husbands. Are we together, members? So the last point the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallama used to be just whenever it came to the matters of his beloved wives. Okay? So please and please, members, as I am winding up our today's lecture, I want us to do each and everything in our lives when we make the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be our role model. Yes, you are studying. Your role model must be the Prophet. You are having friends. Be with them according to the way the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was. You are a husband. Make your image, your big role model to be the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But nowadays we tend to follow various people. I am following Robert Chagulanyi Bobby Wine. When he takes Bobby to the beach, I also take my wife to the... Which is not bad. Okay? Let us be with our role models. And that role model must be the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I wish to stop here. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those ones who listen to words and then they pick better from them. Rabbana taqabbal minna innaka anta samiul alim wa tubu alayna ya maulana innaka anta tawabur rahim. Allahumma ati nufusana taqwaha wa zakiha fa anta khayru man zakaha anta waliyuha wa maulaha bi rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin. Allahumma yassir lana fi a'malina. اللهم يسل لنا في دروسنا اللهم كن معنا في كل شيء ربنا عليك توكلنا وإليك أنبنا وإليك المصير سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما اللهم احفظنا واحفظ أسرتنا اللهم احفظنا واحفظ آبائنا وأمهاتنا وزوجاتنا وأولادنا وجميع المسلمين من مشارق الأرض ومغاربها ربنا اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وارحمهم كما ربونا صغارا وصل اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وسلم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.